Shashi Tharoor ji.
Yes, sir. So I'd like to oppose them both in one speech, if I may. Because just one general observation and four quick points to save time because of the late hour. First, this government has this habit of repeatedly relying on the ordinance route to bypass the scrutiny of Parliament. In 2017, such re-promulgation of ordinances was upheld by the Honourable Supreme Court as a fraud on the Constitution, which is fundamentally at odds with the principle of parliamentary supremacy. So we are meeting here at 11:40 at night to assert that Parliament should be heard on this kind of subject. And I must say that it's necessary that the requirements spelt out under Article 123 of the Constitution must be met before resorting to the extraordinary step of promulgating an ordinance. But before I get into the substance, I would like to direct the attention of the Minister towards the National Commission for Homeopathy Bill passed by the Parliament this week. Section 57(1) of the bill calls for the Homeopathy Central Council Act 1973 to stand repealed, and the Central Council of Homeopathy, constituted under Section 3 of the Act, to stand dissolved. This defeats the whole objective of the discussion we are having on this ordinance today, because if the Central Council shall cease to exist in the first place, why are we bringing in a law that extends its tenure, sir? If you look at the statement of objects and reasons of this ordinance, Central Councils are responsible for the regulation of the educational standards of homeopathy. This function of the Central Council shall be encompassed within the functions carried out by Homeopathy Education Board, and that's stipulated in the National Commission for Homeopathy Bill. Now, this is apparently something that says that it will determine the standards of education and oversee all aspects relating thereto. And the President of the Homeopathy Education Board and the heads of various institutes specializing in homeopathy are members of the National Commission for Homeopathy itself. Given all of this, sir, we've just passed a law this week. The main question to the ministers, isn't the Central Council then redundant? And I think the minister in response should please give a clarification on this fundamental point. Then I'd like to point out that there's repeated extension and supersession of both councils. The Central Government Act in 2018 sought to supersede the Central Council and appoint a Board of Governors in its place. In 2018, the ordinance and the bill that replaced it said the Central Council would be constituted within 1 year. A year passed, then in 2019, the government promulgated another ordinance seeking to extend the time period for reconstitution of the Central Council to 2 years. They had been unable to establish the Central Council. Another year passed. Sure enough, in April this year, the government promulgated yet another ordinance, this time extending the time period to 3 years. They still had failed to elect a Central Council for homeopathy, even though 2 years had now elapsed since the decision was first made. Who knows for how many more years the government plans to keep up this annual charade, sir? This year, it started the same process with the Indian Medical Central Council, providing for it to be superseded and reconstituted within 1 year. Should we expect that process also to suffer from the same inordinate delay that the Homeopathy Central Council has done? Then, sir, the initial move to supersede the Central Council in 2018 was meant to bring transparency, accountability and quality within the homeopathy education system. The government has achieved the opposite by not following any democratic procedures in establishing the Board of Governors and then exercising complete control over it. There are too many instances of the Ministry of Ayush taking up the role of regulator in lieu of the council, which is an overreach by the ministry into roles that should be delegated to autonomous bodies. The directions of the central government to the board stand final with regard to policy direction. So that means that you're giving yourself, sir, the government, the final decision-making power over the reconstituted Central Council. This is further evidence of over-centralization in this government, taking away the autonomy of the regulatory bodies. Similarly, there's no specific criteria or adequate representation of the Board of Governors. But in the interest of time, I will try and wrap up with the final concern, which I know the minister is aware of. I've mentioned it in an earlier debate, the potential legitimization of quackery. The Ministry of Ayush is in charge of permitting persons and colleges to offer homeopathic courses and to expand such courses. It has also been promoting Clause 49 of the National Medical Commission Bill 2017, which focuses on bridge courses that allow homeopathic professionals to prescribe allopathic treatments in rural areas. Then the bill to constitute the National Commission provides for an interface between the Indian system of medicine, homeopathy, yoga, naturopathy, and modern systems of medicine. This means essentially that the Indian Medical Association's concern that giving such doctors, Ayush doctors, the ability to prescribe allopathic medications and perform allopathic procedures will officially amount to legitimization of quackery, lower the standards of rural health. Allopathic treatment can now be delivered by homeopathic practitioners who, after all, have taken a shortcut instead of taking an MBBS, and this could absolutely reduce the efficacy of medicine. And I'd like Dr. Harshvardhan, both as an allopathic doctor and as the minister responsible for this, to kindly address this concern. Sir, the regulatory mechanism is unclear thanks to the passing of the National Commission for both these areas. I would urge the government to put an end to this process of extensions and supersessions once and for all. Either subsume the function of the central councils within the respective national commissions, or establish a single body for each of these fields with adequate representation from the states and from all relevant institutions. This alone will ensure greater transparency, better accountability, and a higher quality of practice and education of these fields of medicine in the country. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, for indulging us.